Hello everyone, this is Ruchita on behalf of CLT Consulting. I welcome you to all on a session of spiral modeling. So guys, in this session we are mainly focusing on introduction, when to use this model, phases of spiral model, advantages and disadvantages of the spiral model. So moving to introduction part, spiral model was defined by Barry Boehm in 1986. Spiral model is basically used for software development lifecycle to build the particular software. It contains the features of prototyping model and waterfall model. So, what is prototyping? Prototyping model is also used for software development, in which a prototype is built, tested and then reworked when needed until the acceptable prototype is achieved. And another one is a waterfall model, which is also used for software development. The whole process of software development is divided into separate phases. So the outcome of the phase acts as an input for the next phase sequentially. This means that any phase in the development process begins only if the previous phase is complete, and these phases are flowing steadily downwards like a waterfall. So that's why it is called as waterfall model. The spiral model is used in a large, expensive and complicated projects. Next is when to use spiral model. When project is large, when risk and cost evaluation is important, projects are from medium to high risk, when requirements are unclear and complex, when changes may require at any time, significant changes are expected. So here is the structure of spiral model. It looks like a spiral, that's why it is called as spiral model. It contains many loops. The exact number of loops of the spiral is unknown and can vary from project to project. Each loop of the spiral is called as phase of the software development process. This model is divided into four quadrants, which is also called as phases. Those are plan, risk analysis, engineering and customer evaluation. The radius of the spiral at any point represent the expenses of the project. Next is the phases in the spiral model. So first phase is plan. In this phase, the objectives, alternatives and constraints of the project are determined and documented. It includes estimating the cost, schedule and resources for the project. The analyst gathers information about the requirements and starts to understand what needs to be done. This phase also includes understanding the system requirements by continuous communication between the customer and the system analyst. Next phase is a risk analysis. During the second quadrant, all the possible solutions are evaluated to select the best possible solution. Then the risk associated with the risk is identified and risks are resolved using the best possible strategy. At the end of this quadrant, prototype is built for the best possible solution. Risk analysis also includes identifying, estimating and monitoring the technical feasibility and management risks such as schedule and cost. At the end of first iteration, the customer evaluates the software and provides feedback. The process of the iterations along the spiral continues throughout the life cycle of the software. Third phase is engineering. The actual development of the project is carried out. This phase includes testing, coding and deploying the software at the customer site. This is the main phase of this model. And the last phase is customer evaluation. This phase is similar to testing phase. Developed product is passed on the customer in order to receive the customer's comments and suggestions. Evaluations take place in every spiral. This model is used in complex projects like working on the missiles or satellites. It's the real-time example of spiral model. The risk and cost both are important aspects of the missiles. The phases of this project, like understanding the basic requirements, need and goal, is the first iteration of this project. It also includes estimating the schedule, time and cost, and various resources is come under the planning, which is also the first iteration of this project. Identifying, estimating and monitoring various risks covered under risk analysis, which is the second iteration of this project. Developing the final model based upon the approved requirements is the third iteration of this project, which is also called as engineering. It includes design, coding and launch of the missile. This is the most crucial iteration of this project. And last iteration is the evaluation, feedback or the limitation. So this is the success story of launching the missile. The spiral model has some advantages and disadvantages. The advantages of this model is like high amount of risk analysis. That's why we can avoid the risk. We can accommodate the changing requirements. Requirements can capture accurately. This model is very useful in mission critical projects. Client users see the system early. We can get early and frequent feedback from users. Additional functionality can be added by later date. So those are the advantages of this model. Here are some disadvantages of this model. It is costly model to use for the small project. Process is very complex. This model also requires lot of documentation. The project success is highly dependent on the risk analysis phase. So this is all about the advantages and disadvantages of this spiral model. Thanks for watching my video. If you like this video, then don't forget to subscribe, like and share this video. Thank you. Bye bye.